Yeah, well, the defense took more than 2 hours to give their closing argument, and there was an hour and a half closing argument before that from prosecutors. Since the burden's on the prosecutors, they get the last word in this case, so they're making their rebuttal right now. When the jury does go out, they're going to have 5 counts to decide on. Let's show them to you. Count 1 is sexual assault from the October 2007 rape that happened in the parking garage at UNR. Count 2 is kidnapping, the woman taken from outside her apartment near UNR in December of 2007. Count 3 is the sexual assault against that same woman, which allegedly happened inside James Bela's truck. Count 4 is murder of Breonna Dennison. It's open murder, which means the jury decides if it's first degree, second degree, or manslaughter. And count 5 is sexual assault against Breonna Dennison. The prosecution made its closing argument, which lasted almost an hour and a half. They hit all the high points, the fiber and DNA evidence linking Bela to the crimes, the strange behavior Bela displayed to the people close to him around the time of the crimes, and when police started questioning him. Prosecutors claimed that Bela saw Breonna on the couch through the front window of that house near UNR. He walked in the unlocked door, they said, and pushed her pillow into her face so hard she bit into it. They think he raped Breonna Dennison in his truck, then killed her, and didn't know what to do with the body. They think he realized it was getting close to the beginning of his Monday morning work shift, so he ditched her just about a mile away in that South Reno field we've all come to know. But the very first thing the prosecutors pointed out goes to Bela's character, the comment he made to a co-worker when Breonna Dennison's body was found that she probably had it coming.
And we've heard testimony that the defendant kind of fancied himself a bit of a comedian. He was a funny guy. So the bitch probably had it coming might be a very poor attempt at humor from anybody other than the person who strangled the life out of Breonna Dennison. You could probably apply that to all three victims in this case. He probably figures that all three of them had it coming.
Well, the defense took a lot longer to make its closing argument, and they tried to create bits of doubt here and there. Why didn't the crime lab videotape their DNA tests? If Bela knows jiu-jitsu chokeholds, why would he use a pillow against Breonna Dennison? And the October rape victim only identified Bela after he was arrested for the murder of Breonna Dennison.
She very well may believe that, but that doesn't make it true. How much easier is it for her to rest at night in the belief that the man who did this to her is facing trial?
And so we're still waiting for the wrap-up of those arguments to the jury. The jury should go out at that point. We expect the judge to allow them to deliberate tonight, but we're not sure how late he'll let them go. Stay tuned to Channel 2 News and, of course, to our Facebook and Twitter feeds for the very latest on what's happening with this case. We're covering the Bela trial live in downtown Reno. Brandon Ridderman, Channel 2 News. Yeah,